So very good morning to all the children of class 10th D. As you can see, I have already written the name of the chapter and characters on the board. We have done part one. But before we start the chapter, I would like to tell you about one campaign organized by CBSE in association with some other government initiatives. That is very prestigious one. The name of this campaign is Yuva Campaign. Y-U-W-A-A. You can read about it, you can Google about it, and you can know more about it. It is a campaign to, you know, create awareness. After pandemic, many people have suffered a lot. So there are n number of activities which would be initiated. No one will speak now, right? So five modules are there in this activity. I would be choosing different students in each module, fine, ranging from 6 to 10. And you would be getting the certificate also after attending the module. That I will be checking on the details and all. So I have chosen few students, already created a group also. In first module, we are going to write an acrostic poem in which one word I have given to them and they are writing one poem. Suppose I say word home. So I will be asking you, what do you think when you think of your home? Some children can say comfort. Fine. Some children can say, when I think of the word home, it means parents. Some will say, ma'am, family. So then jolt down those words. Clear, Saksham? After thinking of the word, jolt down few more words which are related to that word. Then you will be writing an acrostic poem on that word. Clear? I have already shared in the group. Those who have participated, you are supposed to submit it today. So rest of the students can participate in next modules. More interesting work coming up, which is some children are good at art. There you will be drawing something and all. Some are good speakers. They can take part in storytelling. Fine. So those who will be interested, I will be choosing you. You can also tell me if you are interested. Okay. Is it clear to all the students here also? If you want to take part in that Yuva campaign, kindly send me your names by today evening only. Fine. So let's start with chapter 100, Dresses, part 2. In part 1, we have read about Brenda Petronsky, a girl coming from Polish-American background, which is not considered good enough. And Peggy and Medi, they keep on poking her, they keep on making fun of her because she wears one dress daily, the blue-colored faded dress. And when suddenly, and same question they keep on asking Brenda, how many dresses did you have? She says, 100 dresses all lined up. How many shoes do you have? 60 pair, all different, lined up in my closet. This is the answer Brenda gives to her friends. Now the question is, why does Brenda say so? Because she is very good at drawing. And she has drawn different 100 sketches of dresses. She was not wrong. She was right when she used to say, I have 100 dresses. Fine. And when that drawing competition came, who won the competition? Brenda Petronsky won that competition. Clear? We have already read this chapter. That how Brenda won. But Brenda was not coming to school since few days. For many days, I must say. And nobody was noticing her. But when her name was announced as the winner of the competition, then Medi and Peggy thought that why she is not coming. And you know that chapter ended when children started having a look of the drawings everywhere. Fine, that their chapter ended. Now in 100 Dresses Part 2, same characters would be there. One more character I'm adding up. Miss Mason, she is the teacher, fine, and the prominent character, father of Brenda. He is another important character we'll read about. His name is Mr. Jan Petronsky. Jan Petronsky. And one minor character is Jake, who's brother of Vanda. But we are not going to read much about this character. But yes, we have to read about father of Vanda. Clear? Now, story ended when they were just visiting and having look at drawings. Suddenly, Miss Mason, she made one announcement, a big announcement. She got a letter from principal's office. And after receiving that application, or you can say letter from the office, it was not an application, it was a letter. So after receiving that letter, she just asked all the students, sit down, settle down fast. I have one announcement for you all. When all the children hear this, fine. They just became quite conscious, okay, that what teacher Miss Mason is going to tell us today. That was a serious concern. Let's read about. Beta, wearing double mask doesn't mean that you are speaking and I'm not able to see, okay? So anyone who would be speaking is not allowed to sit here. Sit straight. While the class was circling the room. So the students sitting at home, kindly open page number 73. I won't be sharing the screen today. You can see in your books also. Clear? While the class was circling the room, the monitor from the principal's office brought Miss Mason a note. A note was brought from principal's office. And what was written in the note? Miss Mason read it several times. What was there that she was reading it several times? And studied it thoughtfully for a while. Then she clapped her hands. Clap doesn't mean in appreciation. She said, okay, settle down. Everyone, sit back in that way. She clapped to capture the attention so that everyone settles down fast. Fine. Attention class. Everyone back to their seat. When the shuffling of feet had stopped and the room was still and quiet, Miss Mason said, I have a letter from Vanda's father that I want to read to you. So what was that note? Very important for you all. That was a note, not a complete letter. What is a note? When you just scribble, you some write something on a paper and you give it to someone, ki convey my message to a person. That is a note only. So that was a note, a message from Vanda's father. And she wanted to read it aloud to the whole class. What was written in the note? Miss Mason stood there a moment. And the silence grew tense, the room grew tense and expectant. Everybody was quite serious that what is it that Vanda's father has written something and Vanda is not coming to school also. Everybody started making speculations that what can it be? The teacher adjusted her glasses slowly and deliberately. Deliberately means knowingly. Her manner indicated that what was coming. This letter from Vanda's father was a matter of great importance. Everybody listened closely as Miss Mason read the brief note. Miss Mason started reading. What was written? Let me read it for you all. Dear teacher, my Vanda will not come to your school anymore. Jake also. Jake is brother of Vanda Petronsky. Now we move away to big city. No more holler polack. What does it mean? You remember when Venda used to come to school, people would call her names. People would make, other students would make fun of her that you are from Polish background. On the basis of her background, on the basis of her name, I told you in the beginning, there are lines where it is written that Venda hailed from American Polish background and her name was quite different. Rest of the names were quite similar, which were acquainted, fine. And her name was quite different in that community, Venda Petronsky. And they would make fun of her name on daily basis. And you remember how introvert she had become. She would never speak. She would never open up about her feelings. She never smiled even. Only single line she would say when they were asking, how many dresses do you have? The only time when she spoke was about dresses and shoes all lined up in my closet. Because she was very much attached to her artwork. At that time she would speak, otherwise she never spoke. What does it show? That Venda's father was very much aware that her girl was being bullied up in the school. She was made fun at by the co-mates. Fine? So now her father has written a letter to everyone that we have moved in big city. No more holler polak. Means you used to call her holler polak, that you are from this background. Now, no need to, that my girl will not be listening to this name. No more ask why funny name. No one would be asking her now that why you have a funny name. Plenty of funny names in the big city. Because in which school she was coming, that was, you can say, that place was not having large population. And that's why she was highlighted. He says, we are moving to big city. Plenty of funny names are there. My daughter will not be the only one. It means maybe he was hurt. That's why he moved to big city. That they were treated like aliens at that place. They were living in Boggins Heights, which was not considered good place. Maybe his father was also suffering same problem the daughter was going through, or the son was also going through. So they have not mentioned, but he was knowing it that his children were facing this problem in the school, that they are mistreated by everyone. So he says, yours truly, Jan Petronsky. So that was a small note, but carrying the deeper meaning. Okay, he was a man of few words. In few words, he's able to make everyone understand. So the ones who are listening here online, kindly send me thumbs up. Those who are sitting at homes, let me check whether you are paying attention or not. Yes, most of you. I could not see Parth. I could not see Prabjot Kaur, Harleen, Laksh Kakkar. Yes. Fine. So now let's continue. A deep silence. A deep silence met the reading of this letter. When Miss Mason started reading this letter, silence prevailed at that time. When do we keep mum? When do we silent ourselves? When we know that we are at fault. Rest of the children never used to make fun, but yes, sometimes they used to call her names. Sometimes they used to laugh the Peggy would treat her. So all were equals in this case. A deep silence met the reading of this letter. Miss Mason took off her glasses, blew on them and wiped them on her soft white handkerchief. She cleans her spectacles. Then she put them on again and looked at the class. And this time when Miss Mason talked, the voice was very low. Why? Our voice is a reaction to what we feel. what we feel are our emotions. And if you are happy, you will be so excited. Yes, I want to tell you about this and all. If you are sad, you won't even like to talk. And if you talk, your tone will be very low. Clear? So our voice is just dependent upon our emotion. She felt really bad that that happened to in her class. She was not aware about it. Now Miss Mason said, I'm sure that none of the boys and girls in room 13 would purposely and deliberately hurt anyone's feelings. Underline, you have a textual question on this beta. Underline, I would be telling you the answers, but right now underline. Teacher says, I'm sure that if anybody has hurt the feelings of Vanda, it was not on a purpose. Deliberately means knowingly, jaan boojh ke to nahi kiya aisa. She's saying, because his or her name happened to be a long, unfamiliar one, because her name was different, doesn't mean that you might have hurt her. I prefer, next page, beta. I prefer to think that what was said in thoughtlessness. So teacher is saying, I hope that whatever you have said to Venda, that was just a casual behavior. In thoughtlessness, you have said. Deliberately, aise kisi ko hurt karna is not at my student's task. This is what she's trying to say. I know that all of you feel the way I do. That this is very unfortunate thing to have happened. Unfortunate and sad both. And I want you all to think about it. So teacher is very polite enough to convey her message to all the children. She's saying that it is very unfortunate or shameful thing that one child who was very promising artist, she has left the school just because people would call her names. They would mock at her because her name was different, her background was different. So she is feeling very low, very bad. The first period was a study period. Medhi tried to prepare her lessons, but she could not put her mind on her work. She had a very sick feeling in the bottom of her stomach. Underline the feelings of Medhi. This is another question in your book. Medhi tried till her stomach tak. They are saying, you know, Medhi was already a poor girl who used to feel bad for Vanda, but she could not tell her friend. True friends are those who will tell you about your bad deeds as well as your good deeds. If you are doing something wrong and your friend is just sending you thumbs up, yes, very good, you have done something marvelous, it means you are in wrong hands, you are with wrong person. That is actually, and you people feel very good because this is the age, beta, when you get provoked easily by others. You do something wrong, and that made a group of people laugh. And you're saying, wow, my friends are happy. They are saying yes to whatever I have done. And that means you will be repeating that action in future. That is distortion to your behavior, your level. Clear? One should behave what suits you. Where do you come from? What sort of families you are coming from? It doesn't mean when Peggy was making fun of Vanda, if one person is banned, doesn't mean Medhi has to jump in. Or at least she could stop her. Now Medhi was actually feeling bad. She was thinking, why did not I stop Peggy of treating Vanda the way she was doing? She was feeling sick. She had not enjoyed listening to Peggy ask Vanda how many dresses she had in her closet, but she had said nothing. She had stood by silently, and that was just as bad as what Peggy had done. Suppose you're not doing anything wrong to your friends. Your friend is doing something bad to someone, but you are standing there silently enjoying that moment. You are equally responsible for it. One person does something wrong, the friend is saying, very good, do it again. It means that friend is also equally responsible for the act. Clear? So Now nobody will ask me to go out, Beta, please. Few minutes are left. Then she had said nothing. She had stood by silently. And that was just as bad as what Peggy had done. Worse than this, she was a coward. Who will tell me the meaning of coward? Who's a coward? Dalpok, the one who does not have the courage. Parikshit, we are not supposed to, you know, chew the gums while sitting in the class. Mind it. So, she felt bad. She felt sick. She had not enjoyed what her friend did. But she was a coward. She was, at least, Peggy had not considered they were being mean, but she, Maddie, had thought they were doing wrong. She could put herself in Vanda's shoes. Now she is feeling that I should have keep myself at Vanda's place. I should have stopped my friend Peggy. Now she's repenting. This is the feeling of repentance and remorse. You can write down the words. Repentance means pachtava. Remorse means sadness, dukh. She was gripped with the feeling of who? Maddie. Maddie was gripped with the feeling of repentance and remorse. Goodness, wasn't there anything she could do? If only she could tell the ones who are trying to talk, beta, questions are coming to you only. The ones who are talking will get the oral comprehension check on the same page. Be ready. Wasn't there anything she could do? If only she could tell Vanda, she had not meant to hurt her feelings. She turned around and stole a glance at Peggy, but Peggy did not look up. Maddie started looking at Peggy sitting at another desk, but Peggy was busy in doing her work. Maybe Peggy had not realized her mistakes since now. So Peggy was busy in completing her work only, but Maddie was restless. Realization has dawned upon her. She, whether Peggy felt badly or not, she, Maddie, had to do something. What did Maggie decide now? Maggie decided something that she would do after the class. Underline that again. This is a question. I'm telling you the answer side by side. See, even then, some of you are not even underlining. It's very difficult to hold a pencil and underline, you know. So she had to find Vanda Petronsky. What she decided that she would be finding Vanda. Maybe she had not yet moved away. Maybe she is still living at Boggins Heights. Maybe Peggy would climb the heights with her. They would tell Vanda she had won the contest. Maybe I will ask Peggy also to join me and go to her house and tell her that how she has won the competition. They thought she was smart. And the 100 dresses were beautiful. So she decided that she would be reaching Vanda. She would be telling her that how beautiful her artwork is. Actually, that was the way of saying sorry. She's not directly. Sometimes we people are so adamant and so egoistic that saying sorry to any person, we feel low. We feel, how can I say sorry to that person? Even to our parents and teachers sometimes. One should have realization of one's mistake. At least Maddie was having realization. Peggy still is not talking about it. Some people do not have any realization. Even then they are doing wrong. They're very casual about what they do. The way their two boys are sitting and talking and not realizing. I must announce the names then. Then, oral comprehension check. Yes. Stand up. What's your name? Vivan. Yes, Vivan. Vivan Uppal. What did Mr. Petronsky's letter say? What was the content of the letter? Nobody will speak. I'm talking to Vivan only. The one who would be answering will be the next one to speak. The question was done when you were in the class only. I asked you that question. Can you answer, beta, please? What's your name? Yes, Harsimran. Harsimran is going to answer this question. What was the content of the letter? Yes, beta, speak loudly. Sit down. So Mr. Petronsky's letter was actually to tell Miss Mason and all these students that they have moved to big city where they will not be facing any discrimination on the basis of their different names and background they are hailing from. That's it. Sit down. Next question goes to this boy, beta. Stand up, Daksh. Daksh, stand up. Yes, your question. Is Miss Mason angry with the class? Yes, don't ask others. The ones who will be speaking, beta, they are the next ones to answer. Is she angry? Yes, you. What's your name? Yes, beta. Farina, tell. Is she angry or unhappy? Yes, she is unhappy. Why so? Sit down. I have not asked you to sit down, okay? You keep standing. So, the teacher, Miss Mason, is unhappy with the class because they have treated a promising child in a very bad manner. They discriminated on the grounds of how different her name was. And it might have affected Vanda a lot. That's why Miss Mason is unhappy with all the students. How does Medi feel after listening to the note from Vanda's father? Parikshit would like to answer? Then keep your mouth shut. How does Medi feel after listening to the note after Vanda's father? Yes, Dakshita is your name. What's your name? Princy, yes, please answer this. How does Medi feel after listening to the note from Vanda's father? But so the answer to this is Medi, already we have underlined. Medi felt restlessness after knowing Vanda Petronsky has left the school. She was unable to concentrate on the topic going on in the class, or she was unable to concentrate on her studies. Sit down, beta. Fine. She started feeling sick in her stomach. She was not able to concentrate on anything because she was feeling guilty. Clear? That's it. What does Medi want to do? Yes, beta. Speak louder. Yes. Last paragraph above the questions only. Medi wanted to find Vanda Petronsky. She wanted to go to Boggins Heights. She wanted to tell Vanda that how beautiful her drawings were. So this is her way of depending. In the last break, you were allowed to go out. Yes, she was feeling like that. You can add up anything into it. Anything.